Well, hello, aeronauts. I hope you find this video entertaining. And of course, as usual, I'm not an instructor, so take it for what it's worth. We're going to talk now today about the double hammerhead. It's kind of a misnomer. Unlike the Aresti namesake, there are no prescribed definitions except that the plane appears to pivot about the z-axis 1.5 times roughly out of the vertical climb. For this reason, folks who spend a lot of time flying competitions in Aresti figures and have perfected their hammerhead can find this very frustrating. All the key features of the hammerhead are really not present in this figure. If you have had trouble doing it, this video might provide an epiphany. You'll also realize that a lot of airshow performers depend on smoke to obscure what's really happening. From the safety perspective, it's not a lot different than a hammerhead. You're not going to lose a lot of altitude, and you do have a potential for developing an inverted spin, because one of the key features of this is a full forward stick, full left rudder, and full throttle. So be prepared for the eventuality of entering an inverted spin unexpectedly. In these clips, I was playing around with the basic double hammerhead to see what works and what doesn't, and perhaps figure out some embellishments that could be added. For this reason, the control inputs shown in here might not match exactly what I'm going to say. I'm aiming this at folks who haven't managed to achieve a double hammerhead and give you a recipe that would give you a good chance of getting it done. Here I've got this prop set up at 2500 RPM and the throttle's wide open. Going in there, we treat the speeds and altitudes the same as we would a hammerhead. Pull almost a vertical, just shy of vertical by about 15 degrees. Lead with a bit of right rudder, holding the left wing a bit higher above the horizon than normal. Not necessary, but it'll make things easier for your first couple of times. About 2 or 3 seconds before the point at which you would normally initiate the hammerhead, apply full left rudder, so you actually got some forward speed left. So full left rudder, as the nose struts through the horizon, so after 90 degrees of pivot, apply full forward stick. This uses the gyroscopic effect to help kick the nose to the left even harder than what you already have going on. Hold the stick at a neutral position from the point of view of aileron. And then from here, just sit back and relax. For situational awareness, follow the horizon from wingtip to wingtip and back again. Fly out the figure as you would out of a normal hammerhead. Once you have the basics down and can reliably obtain a double pivot, there's a lot to play with. Small inputs here and there on the pitch and aileron can have large impacts on the form of the figure. Hope you have fun with this. See you around.